Since Mr. Lynch is recognized for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Will the chairman help me with a term here? Does the chairman know why the line was drawn at 80%? Was there a study done, or it says principally engaged in official time, and then it says 80% in the legislation? Well, my point is that it's an arbitrary and capricious line that's been drawn here. There's nothing, there's no magic to it. It's just, I believe the sponsor of the bill just came up with 80% and figured out, stick it in there. The problem is that it limits a constitutional right of these workers to actually bring their grievances forward and have the right to free speech and in the workplace. It is important to note that if an individual union steward was working on a case of sexual harassment, has been brought up by the previous speakers, and reached that 80% limit, that person would be confronted with the dilemma of either pursuing the case beyond 80% and losing their pension time, or giving up the case, in which the grieved employee suffering from sexual harassment would be harmed. And that would be bad in both cases. And, I think it's fair to say it's a prior restraint on a constitutional right in any event. The interesting thing here is that the management side gets no penalty. So they can work on matters of labor relations and personnel policies till the cows come home, and they are not penalized. So I think you've got an equal protection problem there. I see the gentleman who's the sponsor of this bill. May I ask Mr. Heiss if there was any magic in the 80% beyond the limit at which someone may be principally engaged in official time? How did we come up with 80%?
Yeah, there's nothing magic about it.
Is there any rational basis?
I'm not looking for magic around here, but there's not. No, listen, last year I introduced a bill.
Did you just think it up? I'm just asking.
Yeah, last year I introduced a bill on official time that was much more stringent than this. I mean, to be honest, if I had my choice personally, any time on official time should not be credited towards retirement because it's not what they were hired to do.
At least you're honest.
Yeah, and so,
so listen, I'm
answering your question.
Okay.
And so we decided, look, my wishes are not going to be sufficient. So let's be as reasonable as we can. 80% seemed like an extremely reasonable amount that if a person's working over 80% of the time in the job that they were not doing a job they were not hired to do, it seems extremely reasonable, okay, beyond reasonable to give that.
Was it derived from any?
I just told you where it was derived. Overly reasonable.
You thought it up? Is that what it is?
Yeah.
You thought it up. Okay, that's fair enough. I'm just trying to
thought it
establish
up
a basis.
Upon what seemed to be overly reasonable.
I understand. No, that's good. I appreciate the gentleman's honesty. I just want to try to set the table for a challenge here, that this is arbitrary and capricious, which is basically you just thought it up, which is good. That kind of fits the definition right there. Okay.
Would the gentleman yield back?
I would certainly yield to the gentleman from Maryland.